and salvage with 14 locations throughout Maine. There's a Martin Surplus and Salvage near you. There's no reason to ever say I should have bought it when I saw it at Martin's. For the Black Bears, under coach Richard Barron, Bella Shaw is the senior. When I say Bella Shaw, I'm sorry, Bella Swan. I beg your pardon. Bella Swan, the senior at 5'11 from Farmington, Utah, childhood development major, did not score yesterday, 5.8 points per game. Michaela Gustafson, a senior at 6'2. She's from Sweden, sociology major, 2 points yesterday, 8.5 on the season. Sophie Vekstrom, the senior at 5'8 from Finland, kinesiology and physical education major, 3 points yesterday, 7.7 on the season. Liz Wood, the senior, 5'10 from Catlett, Virginia, biology pre-med major. She had 13 points, 11 rebounds, second straight double-double for Liz, 9.8 points, 7.3 rebounds per game. She is now 8 points away from her 1,200 point in Maine history. Also, Ziggy Koitsa. Ziggy comes in as the junior at 5'8 from Vienna, Austria, biology major, 16 points yesterday, 16.7 on the season, double digits all six games and 11 straight contests. Swan, Gustafson, Vekstrom, Wood, and Koitsa. For the Missouri State Bears under Kelly Harper in her third year, Kenzie Williams, she is a preseason All-Missouri Valley Conference player. 5'10 senior from Mount Vernon, Missouri. 13 points a game, had 12 yesterday in their loss to Stanford. Hillary Quantel. Quantel is a senior at 6'1 from Atwood, Kansas. 9.2 points per game, 12 yesterday. Aubrey Buckley, a sophomore, 6'2 from Springfield, Missouri. She's averaging 5.3 points a game, had 4 yesterday. Tiana Snow, a senior at 5'10. Snow ranked 6th all-time in the school's history in steals. She's averaging 10 points a game. She had 13 yesterday. She's from Blue Spring, Missouri. And Riley Rose, the first true freshman to start the opener for Missouri State since 2010. She is averaging 4 points a game. She did not score yesterday. Williams, Quantel, Buckley, Snow, and Rose are officials. Lisa Mattingly, Ed Selasky, and Chancey Munich. There are starting lineups, and they are brought to you by Martin Surplus and Salvage. With 14 locations throughout Maine, there's a Martin Surplus and Salvage near you. There's no reason to ever say I should have bought it when I saw it at Martin's. Noticed here on the big screen center court scoreboard, they just showed the opening video that Maine has at home games. They played that. They also played Missouri State's opening video they have for their home games. That's a kind of a really nice touch here down in Florida at the Gulf Coast Classic. And this is in its third year. They have a second one they've started for the women's game in Austin. And to learn before the game, there's plans to begin a third one next year in Vegas. And in a couple of years after that, hopefully have a fourth one of these 8-team, 3-day tournaments in Vancouver, Washington. That would be kind of cool. University of Maine women's basketball is proudly presented by Bangor Savings Bank. At Bangor Savings Bank, you matter more. Of course, we are coming to you on the Black Bear Sports Network, heard on Oldies 94.1, WGUI, also AM 1230. And we're streaming online at goblackbears.com. And I believe that we are the audio for the video stream today here from the Gulf Coast Showcase. As the man running all the controls here, Marcus, hooked into our board earlier today. So a little shout out for Marcus. We're about ready to get this one underway. Maine on the home white. Still go from the right to left on your radio dial here in the first half. Lisa Mattingly throws the ball up. The tip is going to be controlled by Missouri State in the road maroon uniforms, going left to right. At the top, Quantel over to the right foul line, extended to Williams. Buckley, now they low left side. With it, it is Rose. Rose dishes it off into the paint. The runner, it is up and in. Basket there by Snow, and it's 2-0 Missouri State. Into the forecourt, Sophie Vekstrom for the Black Bears. Bounce pass on the right side to Gustafson. Holding, looking, now gives it off over to Koitsa. Koitsa drive. She uses the window, and that's good, and we're tied at 2. So it is tied at two. Quetza with her first hoop of the day. Williams on the top. Looks over. Finds Rose. Rose ball fakes. Left foul on extended to Snow. Inside they go. The shot up for Quantel. No good. Rebound punched out and controlled by Missouri State. Was in and out of the hands of a Black Bear, but punched out and kept alive by the Bears from Missouri State. Snow, right foul on extended. Skip pass left side, quick three, off no good. Again, another offensive rebound. That one up, no good. And Liz Wood grabs the rebound this time for Maine. So three cracks at it for Missouri State. Well, unable to cash in. Here's Quates into the forecourt, knotted at two. 8:35 in the first quarter. Gustafson at the elbow, left side, looks over to Wood, foul line extended, man-to-man being played here by Missouri State. Liz with a dribble, crosses over, drives down the lane, left side, puts it up, and it's around and down. Liz Wood gives Maine the lead, 4-2. Liz tying Tracy Fernette all-time scoring-wise, shot up, no good. Offensive rebound, Quantel up and in. Quantel got that offensive rebound, and right now Missouri State doing a great job on the boards. It's tied at two. Probably tied at four, second tie in the ball game. Here's Wood, left side. Gives it off over to Swan. Now Quetza at the top. Wood offset right. Puts the dribble down. Liz swings it out. Now Quetza drives. Her jumper off no good. Rebound pulled down by Rose of Missouri State. Into the forecourt quickly. Crosses over at the foul line. At the elbow. Down the lane. Puts up the shot. Maybe partially deflected. In and out. Rebound again. Grabbed by Liz Wood. She had a fight for that one. Her second rebound. She's had two straight double-doubles for the Black Bears. 19 in her career. At the top, Liz looks over to Bella Swan. Bella pulls up. Her 12-footer off glass. Too short. Rebound. It's controlled by Williams of Missouri State. Into the forecourt on the right side. Down to the foul line. Over the lane, her shot up, it crawls over the iron. A good Missouri State takes the lead by a score of 6-4. That's their second lead change here in the early going. 7:08 to play here in the first quarter. Quetza looks for help, finds Gustafson at the right elbow. Michaela puts the dribble down into the paint, looks over baseline. Here's Quetza off the window, and we are tied at six. Second basket for Ziggy, third tie in the ball game. Rose into the forecourt for Missouri State. 6:45 to play here in the first quarter of action. Snow, left foul on extended to Rose at the top. Yells out the offensive instructions, almost knocked away by Ziggy Quetza. Maine in their zone defense, driving Williams. Her shot up and in, she walked around a defender and gets her second hoop of the day. Missouri State 8, Maine 6. 6:25 to play, first quarter. Quetza into the forecourt. Looks over to Gustafson, to Quetza. Ziggy, left foul line extended to Wood, thought about the three, now looks over to Swan, Bella with the basketball. Bella, out top, Quetza, looks inside, right foul line extended, Vekstrom for three, off and no good, hit on the iron twice, rebound is pulled down by Williams. Thought maybe on that second bounce it might get down low, ball deflected out of bounds and it'll be tipped out by Maine. I think Maine thought it was going to go off of Missouri State. Into the ball game for Maine, it will be Chantel Charles, the senior, 5'11 from London, psychology major, 6.2 points per game. Into the ball game, Lisa Fruitt for Missouri State, sophomore at 5'10. She's averaging 12 points a game. Also, they've got another game. Oni Osimhen. Osimhen is a junior, 6'3, 2 points a game. Fruitt with a basketball. Fruitt starts to drive down the lane. Gets it off to Williams. Bounce pass in. Quantel, her turnaround is good. Missouri State with its biggest lead. They lead by four, 10-6. 5:35 to play here, first quarter. With it, it's Gustafson. Looks over. Quetza sees an opening. Pulls it back out. Wood takes the three. That's off glass. Bingo! Liz Wood. First three of the day for the Black Bears. Maine trails by one, and the first foul of the day will belong to Chantel Charles. Missouri State also got Grace Vander Whitey into the ball game. Whitey's a freshman at 5'11 from West Des Moines, Iowa, averaging 2 points a game. They only put 2 points on the board for Liz Wood, so maybe they only counted that as a two instead of a three. No, they went up to three, yes. Now they added the extra point. 10-9, Maine trails by one. Missouri State with it. Vanderweide looks over to the left side. Williams, she's going to take a three. That's off glass, no good. Another offensive rebound from Missouri State. And right now they are dominating the boards, and Maine's got to do a better job of getting those offensive rebounds, or defensive rebounds, I should say. Vanderweide looks over to the left side. Skip pass to the right. Back over to Vanderweide at the foul line. Looks left to Williams. Williams starts to drive, leans in. Shot was partially deflected out of bounds. Ziggy Koitza knocked it out. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Media timeout. We'll take one also. 4:50 to play here in the first quarter. It is Missouri State 10, Maine 9. This is Black Bear Basketball from Learfield Sports. Coming to you from the U.S. Cellular broadcast booth, U.S. Cellular, hello, better. Don't forget, with U.S. Cellular and their 4G LTE, you can post, text, and stream in the middle of anywhere. Maine 4-for-7 from the floor. Missouri State is 5-for-11, the big number. 4 offensive rebounds for Missouri State. Totally, Maine has just 2 rebounds. Down low, ball deflected, and first turnover of the ball game on the deflection by Wood, picked up here by Koitza for Maine. Gustafson at the top, looking, waiting, patient, looks for Koitza on the right foul line extended. Maine trails by one, 10-9 to Missouri State. Wood at the top of the key, looks over to Koitza, starts to accelerate on the right side, wants to go baseline, has it shut off, looks to Vekstrom, she'll take a three, off, no good, rebound tipped and controlled by through it for Missouri State. Now here's Vanderweide. Pass deflected, nope, thrown away. Second turnover for Missouri State. They turn the ball over 14 times a game. Lauren Bodine will check in for the first time for Maine, the senior, 5'8 from Louisville. Pre-med biology major, did not score yesterday, 4.2 points per game on the season. With the basketball, Gustafson picked up on a double team, finds Wood at the top as Liz pops out high, now looks to Charles, left foul line extended. Down low, they'll get it off over to Gustafson, holding, looking, back to Charles. Over to Wood, Wood a little baseline, has it shut off on the left side, now to Gustafson. Out top, it is Koitza, 8 on the shot clock. Wood fakes, kicks it into the corner. There's Bodonek, says Charles takes the 3, off, no good. Rebound offensively by Michaela Gustafson, but she traveled. I didn't think so, but what I think and what the referee thinks are two different thought processes. Thought she tapped the ball up into the air and then grabbed it, but the official ruled out a carry. Williams with the basketball on the right side. Here's Vanderweide at the left elbow, probably right elbow, looks over to Williams. Williams wants to go left, now goes back to right to Vander Whitey. Foul line extended down long baseline. Back out to Vander Whitey at the foul line, kicks it back out. Fruent starts to drive on the right side, has it shut off by Wood. Six on the shot clock, back to Williams, left side they go, Vander Whitey. She's wide open, takes the three, off no good. Rebound whistle. And it will be a foul on the rebound, and it will go against Osimenin. That is going to be her first and the team's first. Lexi Hughes will check in for Missouri State. A 5'8 junior from Kansas City, Kansas, averaging 5 points a game, had two yesterday. Wood will bring it up, acting as the point guard this time up the court for the Black Bears. Into the corner to Bodine, bounce pass, Gustafson wanted to go wrong across the baseline, and she turned the ball, kind of rolled up her arm, and it went out of bounds. Right idea, she had an open player, Chantel Charles, in the left corner, and as she made that turn to make the pass, the ball just rolled right up her arm. Kind of like a shortstop in baseball where the ball just rolls up even though you make a great fielding play. Here's Fluent. Shot no good, and a rebound. It's Michaela Gustafson. Missouri State 0-for-3 from behind the arc. Into the forecourt. Here comes Koitza. Looks to Wood out top. Charles. Left side they go. Bodine. Foul line extended. Lauren with the basketball. LB looking now. Bounce pass down into the left corner. It's Wood. Wood fakes. Wood wants to go baseline. Skips it over to the right side. Charles open for three. Sets up. Off. No good. Offensive rebound. It is fought for by Michaela Gustafson. Maine doing a better job on the boards here. Last few moments. Now with it, Gustafson on the left foul line extended. 2:12 to play here in the first. 10-9 in favor of Missouri State. Bodine at the top of the key. Lauren looking. Now goes to Wood. Offset left. Back over to Lauren. She's going to take the three. Off no good. Maine is now 1-for-5 from behind the arc as that ball kicked out of bounds, and it will be a dead ball rebound for Missouri State. Rachel Swartz, a junior, 6'3", from Stanwood, Washington, checks in for Missouri State, 2.4 points a game. She scored a bucket yesterday against Stanford. Fruent at the top, bounce pass over to Hughes. Right side, Buckley inside, Wood with a steal. Liz Wood with another steal, 2-on-1. Wood fakes the pass, lays it up and in. Oh, what a pretty fake by Liz. She's got 7, and Maine is on top, 11-10. Fourth lead change in this first half. With a basketball, here is Fruin. Has it shut off, Charles knocks it away. Loose on the court, still loose on the court. Tie up, possession arrow, Maine. Charles went in there for the steal. Charles a little slow in getting up. And they were going to give Liz Wood a breather, but now they're going to bring Charles off. Ziggy's getting a breather. Also, Koitza comes out as Swan checks back in, as does Vekstrom. So it's Vekstrom, Swan, Bodine, Gustafson, and Wood. Liz left foul line extended. Pass is errant, but it's saved by Lauren Bodine. Back out towards midcourt, Wood with it. Wood, left-handed dribble. Into the corner, ball deflected, and a nice steal there by Rose. Here comes Rose, accelerating, crosses over, puts up the shot, it's in and out. Rebound, loose, foul, Maine. And the foul is going to go Liz Wood, her first. They're going to say that Buckley, who got the rebound, was going back up for the shot, so she will go to the line for repair, where she is 13-for-18 on the year. First one is good, and we are knotted at 11. Fourth tie in this first quarter. Chance to give Missouri State the lead back, and she does. So Buckley with a pair of points from the line. Here's Vekstrom, drives the lane. It's wide open, and Sophie lays it up and in, and Maine's back on top. 13-12 with 42 seconds to play here in the first quarter of action. Swartz looks to Rose. Rose ball fakes back over to Hughes. Baseline, they give the ball. Going back out to the elbow. Buckley left side. Her shot no good. Someone lost a sneaker. One of the Missouri State players is playing without a sneaker, and one of the officials picked it up, and I don't know if I've ever seen that. I think it's Snow playing with only one sneaker right now. 13 seconds to play here in the first quarter. Bella Swan at the top of the key. Looks to Wood for three. Off, no good. Rebound fought for, and that's going to end the first quarter of play. Entertaining first quarter. Maine on top by a point. It's the Black Bears 13, the Missouri State Bears 12. This is Black Bear basketball from Learfield Sports. ...13-12 here. The law firm of Lanham, Blackwell & Baber is a proud sponsor of the Maine Black Bears. Their experienced attorneys are ready to help you, your friend or family, if you're injured in a car accident or by a defective product. Call Lanham, Blackwell & Baber at 942-2898 or visit their website at lanhamblackwell.com. University of Maine basketball, University of Maine women's basketball, proudly presented by Bangor Savings Bank. At Bangor Savings Bank, you matter more. Maine on top, 13-12. We had six lead changes in that first quarter and four ties. Maine shot 6-for-14, 1-for-7 from behind the arc for the Black Bears. Missouri State, 0-for-4 from long distance. They are 5-for-15 from the floor, and they did not make a field goal in the final 5 minutes of that first half. Snow with a sneaker back on, has it for Missouri State as they start with the basketball to begin the second quarter. Williams at the elbow, runner through the lane, off the glass, no good. Rebound batted out long. They do a lot of slapping it back out. Rose picked that one up off the floor. Then taken away by Maine on the turnover. That is the fifth turnover for Missouri State. Black Bears up by one. Wood bounce pass. Gustafson at the right elbow. Looks inside to Wood. Catches it. Lays it up on the reverse. There is the 1,200 point in the career of Liz Wood. And Maine builds the lead to 3-15-12. In this game, she's already passed Tracy Fernand and Ashley Underwood on the all-time scoring list. 10th all-time now in scoring for Maine. Inside shot foul. It's going to go on Maine. It will be two shots. Liz Wood with her 1,200 career point. And the foul on Maine was whistled against whom? Did not, you know, on Lauren Bodine. First foul shot is good for Schwartz. First on Lauren for Schwartz. She is 1-for-2 on the line, now 2-for-3 on the season. Chantel Charles comes back in, as does Ziggy Koitza. Wood gets a breather, as does Bodine. Foul shot is no good, and Chantel Charles gets the rebound. 15-13, Maine on top with a basketball. Here's Koitza. Koitza on the right side. Ziggy with a dribble, left-handed. Spins to the right side, looks over to Vekstrom. Inside, Gustafson uses the window. Too strong, but she's fouled. Foul will go on Snow, and it will send Michaela to the free throw line, where she's 11 for 16 on the season. University of Maine basketball brought to you in part by EBS Building Supplies. From basement to roof, indoors and out, EBS Building Supplies can do, just ask. First one for Michaela, back iron, no good. She'll have one more. Coming to you from the U.S. Cellular broadcast booth, U.S. Cellular, hello, better. Maine 15, Missouri State 13, 8:54 to play here in the first half. Here's the second one for Michaela. It is good. Her first point of the afternoon, and Maine builds the lead to three, equals their biggest lead at 16-13. Here's Rose with the basketball for Missouri State. Tipped and stolen away by Michaela Gustafson. And that is the sixth turnover for the Missouri State Bears. Into the forecourt. With it, it is Koitza. Goes strong, little hoop, lays it up, no good. Contact, nothing called, rebound, Snow. Into the forecourt, Snow with a right-handed dribble. Goes to the left, goes back to the right, down the lane. Runs into Gustafson, her shot no good. Offensive rebound though, picked up by Missouri State, then batted away, and it's going to be controlled here by the Black Bears. Vekstrom with it out under Koitza. Koitza into the forecourt. Maine, bounce pass down to Swan. Bella at the left block. Bella backs into the paint, kicks it back over to the right side to Charles. She sends it out to Koitza. 16 on the shot clock, so plenty of time for Maine. They can be patient. Koitza with a left-handed dribble, looks over baseline. Swan inside. Gustafson, tough catch. No, taken away. Screen there for a second by one of the officials. Screen was taken away by Williams. Now here comes Missouri State. Shot off on the baseline. Kick it back out over to Snow at the top. Over to Rose on the left foul line extender. Rose looking. Finds Williams. Back over to Snow. Foul line right out top. Buckley long lead in. The shot up. Quantwell is good. 16-15. Maine's lead is at 1. 7:30 to play here in the first half. Quantwell with 6 points here in this first half for Missouri State. Bounce pass, it will be Gustafson. She goes strong to the hole. Her runner is good, Michaela. Her first field goal of the afternoon, 18-15. Maine on top by three. 7:10 to play in the second quarter. Here's Rose at the top. Over to Quantel left side. Now they quicken to the right side to Williams. Williams wants to go baseline, a bumping foul. Chantel Charles just picks up her second. Now will be the second on Maine as well. Anna Heise checks in for the first time for Maine, the senior from Germany, 6'3", journalism major, 1.3 points per game. Lauren Bodine comes in as well. So for Maine, it is Wood, Koitza, Bodine, Vekstrom, and Heise. Ball comes in to Snow, her runner up and in. Second basket by Snow, 18-17, Maine's lead is at 1, 6:50 to play. Here's Heise, looks to Bodine. Lauren thought about the three. Now with it, it's Vekstrom, back over to Bodine on the right side. Lauren puts the dribble down, her bounce pass, and it kicked. And it is going to be kicked, and it will be back up to 15 seconds on the shot clock. Missouri State has freshman Danielle Glitzen into the ball game from Victoria, Minnesota. 2 points yesterday, 2 points per game. Comes into Wood, back to Koitza, behind a screen, takes the three, bingo! Barely touched the net. 7 for Ziggy. Maine 21, Missouri State 17. 6:20 to play here in the first half of action. It's Williams. Williams wants to go baseline to the right side. Does, has a shutoff, kicks the pass back out. Snow open for three at the top. Off, no good. Rebound, Maine. Liz Wood with that rebound. Into the forecourt. It's Koitza. Ziggy drives the lane, uses the window to perfection. There's the Ziggy drive. A timeout on the court. Maine on top by a score of 23-17, 5:56 to play here in the first half. This is Black Bear Basketball, and we want to let you know that this timeout is brought to you by Quality Jewelers. Is it time for a new diamond or a diamond upgrade? If so, visit Quality Jewelers in the Penobscot Plaza, 57 Washington Street in Bangor. Now I can say, this is Black Bear Basketball from Learfield Sports. Maine Dairy and Nutrition Council reminds you to be a winner and fuel up to play 60. Eat great-tasting, nutritious-rich foods, including low-fat and fat-free dairy, and get active for at least 60 minutes a day. Maine 23, Missouri State 17. Liz Wood, 10th all-time scorer in Maine history. She jumped three spots in this game, passing Tracy Furnett, Ashley Underwood, actually two spots, and now at 1,200. Only the 10th player in Maine history to score 1,200 points. And now Liz has another steal. Going to be finishing her career as one of the all-time stealers in Maine history. And I mean that in a good sense. Wood top of the key. With it, it's Koitza. Ziggy into the corner of Vekstrom. Vekstrom looks over left side. Lauren Bodine takes the three. Off, no good. Rebound hit off of Maine on the way out. Maine is 2-for-8 from behind the arc. 2-for-9, I beg your pardon now. 10-for-20 from the floor. Missouri State 7-for-21 from the floor. They are 0-for-5 from long distance. They have the ball to Snow. Snow, left side, wants to drive. Kicks it inside. Tie up. Bodine gets her hand in there, and the possession arrow is pointing Maine's way. Here's Koitz into the forecourt for Maine. They're on top, 23-17. Inside 5 minutes to play. Wood drives the lane, kicks it over to Vekstrom, out top to Koitz. Little up fake at the left elbow, picks up the dribble. Now looks out over to Vekstrom, back to Koitz at the top. Left side they go, Heise inside to Vekstrom on the baseline. Back over to the right side to Bodine. Bounce pass down into the corner right side. It is Koitz at the top. They give it to Vekstrom. Her runner dishes it inside to Heise. Back out over to Koitz. Three on the shot clock. Ziggy gives it to Wood. The release of the shot. It's going to be short. Maine had some opportunities there. Matter of fact, looked like Anna Heise had a great look, and she passed that up. Swan and Gustafson back into the ball game. Bodine and Heise come out. And of the forecourt, it is Gitson. Gitson for Missouri State. Looks over to the left foul line extended. Now with it, Quantwell. Williams into the paint on the left-handed dribble. Ball deflected out by Koitz on an attempted pass to Hughes. Debbie Antonelli, who is one of the, I guess you could say, movers and shakers in this tournament, is going to join us at halftime. Another tie-up, possession arrow this time pointing Missouri State's way. And Dave, if Maine ever gets into one of these types of situations again, fans, you got to make the trip because it's a great venue, great opportunity to see all kinds of great women's basketball. And there's going to be a blocking foul. It's going to go on Sophie Vekstrom. Her first, team's third. 4:03 to play. Maine on top here, 23-17. At the top, it's Gitson. Looks over to the left foul line extended, finds Williams. Out top to Hughes. Hughes drives the lane left side. Her runner off, no good. Rebound, Liz Wood. Liz is right now 9 rebounds away from 700 career rebounds to go along with those 1,200-plus points. Here's Koitza. Koitz, a little acceleration down the lane. Bounce pass back out to Swan. Now over to Koitz at the top. Gustafson to Koitz, left foul on extended. Wood at the top. Liz looks inside. She starts to drive. 5 on the shot clock to Swan. Swan got to hurry. Now gives it over to Koitz. Koitz, a long three off, no good. And again, sometimes you'll see Maine do that, and there's another perfect example. There have been two trips where they're patient, and that's what Coach Barron talks about, being patient, but sometimes a little too patient. A few opportunities there, shot opportunities. The Black Bears passed up. Sometimes being unselfish is too selfish. See who the foul's on a main. It's either Gustafson or Wood. It's on Michaela, her first. Team's fourth. Into Williams for Missouri State on the left side. Foul line extended. Behind the back dribble. Williams over to the right side. Three-pointer fired up. Bingo, that is good. First three of the day. That's from Lisa Fewitt. Fruitt with that three, and all of a sudden it's a three-point ball game. Maine 23, Missouri State 20. Wood at the top. Liz looks over to Koitza. Foul line extended. Little up fake. Koitza kicks it right back. Foul line. Wood, she fakes into the corner. Vekstrom for three. Off, no good. Rebound. It's going to be over the top. Michaela Gustafson picks up the foul. Her second, team's fifth, will walk down the other end and shoot foul shots. Fans want to remind you there's some great news for all pizza lovers. Papa John's would like to offer all fans listening to today's game 50% on all online orders at participating Papa John's locations in Maine and New Hampshire now until the end of the day tomorrow. Join us or join them for the online code BB50. That's BB50. Just use that code and you're going to get that 50% off when you order at papajohns.com. Enjoy and thanks to Papa John's. First foul shot for Osiminen is no good. She'll have one more. She's 2 for 4 on the season. Had 6 points yesterday. Makes the second. That's her first point, and Missouri State has pulled to within two, 23-21. Wood with the basketball. Left foul line extended. Finds Bella Swan. Over to Koitza. Koitza tries to come around the corner. Koitza into the corner. Gives it over to Vekstrom. Back to Heise. Out top to Koitza. 7 on the shot clock. Vekstrom. Sophie now finds Koitza for 3 from the left side. Bingo! And the 7th time this year, dating back to last year, the 12th time in a row that Ziggy Koitza has been in double figures for the Black Bears. Maine 26, Missouri State 21. With a basketball. It is Quantel. Now to Fruitt. Back to Hughes, left side, Williams, quick three, bingo. Caught that and fired. Matter of fact, she was ready to shoot that before she even caught it. Beautiful, fluent move there. And it's 26-24. Maine sees its lead cut to 2 with 1:30 to play here in the first half. On the left side with a basketball, Vekstrom. Three-pointer for Koitza, bingo. 15 first half points for Ziggy. Quantel, her three. It's no good. Rebound. Fought for. Controlled again by Missouri State. They've done a nice job on the offensive boards. A lot of times just punching that ball out. Down the lane, Fruitt. Her little runner is good. Daylight for Fruitt. She's got 5. 29-26 Maine on top. 52 seconds to play here in the first half. Here's Vekstrom over to Heise. Wood, top of the key, left side, Swan. Bella, skip pass to Vekstrom, out over to Koitza. Back into the corner, right side, Vekstrom to Wood, right foul line extended. Liz pulls up her jumper, she gets fouled, going to the line, and she'll shoot a pair. Interested in earning your degree online from the University of Maine? Go to online.umaine.edu to learn more about UMaine's online graduate and undergraduate degree program. UMaine Online, be a Black Bear from anywhere. Liz makes the first. Her first free throw of the day. Liz with double digits, as is Ziggy. They've got 25 of the 30 points for Maine. Make it 26. Liz with 11. 31-26, Maine on top here by 5 with 30 seconds to play here in the first half. There's about a 2.5-second differential on the game clock and shot clock, and it went right through the wickets of Williams and a turnover for Missouri State. Not to lean on my baseball analogies, that was when it went right between the shortstop's legs. Pulled the glove up a little too quick. So Maine now with 24.5 seconds, they can hold for the last shot. They're ahead by 5. Would like to take a bigger lead into the locker room, and it will come into Koitza. Ziggy into the forecourt. Ziggy in that right corner. Back out over to Wood. Wood, little up fake. Back to Koitza. And a timeout call by Coach Barrett. He was not happy with whatever the offense the Black Bears ran. So with 12.8 seconds to go, Richard will use a timeout here and discuss it with his team. They've got a 5-point lead. And again, another strong defensive effort for the Black Bears. Remember, yesterday they held Dayton. And I know everyone wants to talk about the offense, but they held Dayton, a team that averaged 83 points a game, down to 58. Missouri State scores almost 71 points a game, and they're at 26 here late in the first half. And only once this year, Maine has given up more than 60 points, and that was at Minnesota when it was the Rachel Banham show. Again, Debbie Antonelli will be joining me here at halftime to talk about this Gulf Coast Classic, and probably nobody in tune with women's basketball more than Debbie Antonelli. Koitza gets fouled by Snow. Six on the shot clock. That's not enough to put them into the bonus. First on Snow. Check that, second on Snow, I beg your pardon. Third on the team. 6 on the shot clock. Koitza gets it into Wood. Liz, baseline, inside to Heise, lays it up and in. First basket for Anna Heise sends the Black Bears to the locker room, up 7. At halftime, it's Maine 33, Missouri State 26. This is Black Bear basketball from Learfield Sports. in play. Maine will have the basketball to start off this second half. Black Bears going from left to right. Starting five in there. Vekstrom a quick three. Bingo! Sophie from downtown. Maine has built its lead up to 10. It's 36-26. Maine on top. Game one of day two of the Gulf Coast Showcase here in Estoril, Florida. Skip pass over to the left side. Now they bring it back out to Rose, inside to Snow. Snow, her runner off the glass, no good. Bella Swan with a rebound. Into the forecourt for Maine, it's Koitza. Koitza goes baseline, into the left corner. Wood open for three, off no good. Swan fights for the rebound, but a nice inside possession there for Snow from Missouri State. She grabs the board, and here come the Bears. It's the Black Bears against the Bears. Down low. Buckley, whistle, travel. That is the 10th turnover in the ball game for Missouri State. Maine with just four turnovers in that first half. Koitza into the forecourt to Wood. As Missouri State extends their pressure a bit, but Maine gets it into the forecourt. Now with a Koitza, breaks a double team, bounce pass over to Swan. Skip pass right side, Vekstrom breaks a double team. Back over to Swan, 16-footer, got it, Bella! On the board for the first time. 38-26 for Maine. They're on top with 8:30 to play here in the third quarter. Out top, it is Quantel. Now to Snow. Snow goes baseline. Her little jumper is good. Six for Snow. 38-28, Maine by 10. 8-10 to play here in the third quarter. On the right side, it is Vekstrom out top. Koitza, here's Vekstrom for another three. Off, no good. Long rebound, it's controlled by Missouri State. Into the forecourt, Snow. Snow stops, looks. Rose, she'll square up for three. That's off the back iron. No good. Offensive putback. Oh, a pretty play there by Tiana Snow. She got that rebound. Put it back up and in. 38-30. Maine's lead is at eight. They have the basketball with 7:38 to play here in the third. Pass from intended for Wood. It's knocked away. A battle picked up by Missouri State. Taken away by Koitza. The shot clock did not reset. It's at 7 seconds of the shot clock. Down to five, whistle. And I think the officials say there was a change of possession. And I think Missouri State had the ball. And they're not going to rule a change of possession. Now they're going to talk about it again. Lisa Mattingly and Cheney Munich, the two of the three officials working the game. It's Ed Skalaski was the trail official. It was right in front of me. The Missouri State player did pick the ball up. I mean, literally, it was a foot for me. And they do set the shot clock back to 30, and that's the right thing. With the basketball, it's Koitza. Gives it to Charles, who checks in for Maine. Bounce pass to Wood at the right elbow. Liz, bounce pass along the baseline. Koitza up and in. Oh, another nice bounce pass by Wood and a sweet finish by Koitza, who has 17. 40-30, Maine on top. 7 minutes to play here in the third. Going baseline. Here's the runner, Snow. Got it, got fouled. And it will be the third foul on Michaela Gustafson. Tiana Snow with her 10th point on the ball game. She'll go to the line, 12 for 17 on the year, to pull Missouri State to within seven, and does. 40-33, Maine on top, Koitz into the forecourt. 6:45 to play, third quarter. Gustafson looks out top, finds Vekstrom. Koitz on the right side, Ziggy. With the dribble, wants to go, now stops. Koitza looks back over to the left side. Charles, she'll take the 16-footer from the left side and swish! Chantel's first basket of the day. 42-33, Maine by 9. 6:20 to play here, third quarter. Here's Williams for Missouri State. Left foul line extended. Takes it to the top of the key, looks down low. Ball gets over to the right side, a long three-pointer, no good. Snow with another offensive rebound and a foul on Maine. It's going to be on Wood, I believe. Second on Liz. Snow with six rebounds. And a nice move in through the paint. Snow keeping Missouri State into this ball game. 42-35. Maine on top. Inside to Wood. Baseline ball was kicked. 19 on the shot clock. Snow with 13 points, six rebounds in the ball game for Missouri State. Three offensive rebounds. Lob to Charles. Looks to Gustafson. Michaela, now to Wood. 12 on the shot clock. Takes a three. Off back iron, no good. Koitza with the offensive rebound. Maine resets. Here's Koitza, goes baseline. Looks to the right side. She gets bumped out. Foul will go on Missouri State. Foul on Buckley. Her first. Koitza left foul on extended. Ziggy wants to go baseline, whistle again, and they're going to get a foul on Quantwell this time. Her first, team second. .529 to play here in the third. Koitza to inbound, baseline left to Wood. Liz wants to go left baseline. It's shut out. Back off to Koitza at the top. Now to Wood, left foul line extended. Up high, actually, offset left. Goes to the right to Koitza. Ziggy at the foul line, starts to drive, kicks it back out to Charles. Charles at the foul line at the left elbow. 8 on the shot clock, gives it back to Ziggy. Ziggy with a dribble. Ziggy at the foul line, looks to Wood. Wood back to Koitza, going to take the three. Off, no good. Wood fights for the offensive rebound. Out of bounds off of Liz. Timeout on the court. 4:56 to play here in the third. It's Maine 42, Missouri State 35. This is Black Bear Basketball from Learfield Sports. Showcase here on the Black Bear Sports Network, including our flagship station, Oldies 94.1 and AM 1230 WGUI, online at goblackbears.com, and Today we are the audio for the stream here at the Gulf Coast Classic. Maine with the lead here, 42-35. And it will be Fruent to Williams. Down low, stolen by Liz Wood. 11th Missouri State turnover, and Liz with another nice theft. Her fourth steal in the ball game. Wood, tough bounce pass. She got it, though. Fought through two screens. Here's Koitza for three. Off, no, oh, bingo! It hit the rim, came back, bounced two more times, and went down, and Koitza with 20 points on the afternoon. And Maine with a 45-35 lead. Here's Buckley over to Williams. Williams with the dribble, being guarded by Vekstrom. Now to Fruent. Fruent at the elbow, bounce pass, kicked by Maine. They'll put a second under the shot clock. We were talking about this with Debbie Antonelli. The officials are really, really good working this tournament. And the good thing about it is, you want me to tell you how, you know, you can tell how confident they are, but they're also out having fun. You sometimes don't see officials have fun when they're doing the game. Shot, no good. Offensive rebound for Snow, but it may be a foul on Maine. I think Charles on the weak side. Yeah, third on Chantel Charles. She's had one in each quarter. Another foul. If that's on Liz, that will be her third. So Liz with three. Maine getting into foul trouble. Liz Wood with three. Michaela Gustafson with three. Chantel Charles with three. 2:50, make that 3:57 to play here in the third. Bounce pass into Fruent, out to Williams. She'll take a three off, no good. Long rebound goes out of bounds. It'll be a Maine ball. Missouri State 2-for-11 from behind the arc. Maine 6-for-19. Wood with a basketball at the left elbow. Looks over to Koitza. Koitza. Bounce pass to Wood, right side, Vekstrom, back to Koitz at the top. Koitz splits a double team, looks over to Charles, into the corner, Vekstrom for three, off, no good. Wood crashes the board, gets the offensive rebound, and it does not go. It bounced on the iron twice, but she'll go to the line for a pair. Liz, who's had back-to-back double-doubles, that's her sixth rebound of the afternoon. There's the first free throw. It's good. Got 12 points first in this half. 10 for 12 from the line on the year for Liz Wood. Try to give Maine a 12-point lead, and she does. Wood with 13. It's 47-35. Maine on top. 3:27 to play here in this third quarter of action. Snow fakes, starts to drive down low. Quantel, her shot no good, but Gustafson just picked up her fourth. And now Heise will have to jump up quickly. Quantel's first foul shot is no good. We are coming to you from the U.S. Cellular broadcast booth. U.S. Cellular, hello, better. 3:15 to play here in the third. Maine on top, 47-35. Quantel will take another one. She is 6-for-9 on the season from the charity stripe. Make it 7-for-10, hits that. 7 on the game. 47-36, Maine on top. Into the forecourt, Charles. Heise came in for Gustafson after Michaela picked up her fourth. Heise at the top, looks over, finds Chantel Charles. Bounce pass to Wood at the elbow, over to Charles. Chantel over to Koitza. Now looks to Heise. Heise, right foul line extended down to Wood. Three on the shot clock. Liz has got to hurry. Baseline jumper, off, no good. Rebound pulled down by Quantel. into the forecourt. It is Vanderwijde. Vanderwijde with the basketball at the left elbow, I mean right elbow. Her bounce pass kind of bounced away from Snow, but she recovered. Snow down the lane, whistle. And it's going to be a foul on Maine on the Snow drive. And right now, Snow is piling the fouls up on Maine. Anna Heise picking up her first. Tiana Snow back at the line. And this first one is good. 14 on the day, 2 for 2 from the line with one to come. Snow's second one, it is good. 47-38, Maine on top, 2:20 to play in the third quarter. Black Bears have led since late in the first quarter. With it is Wood down to Charles, trying to get a pass to Heise, saved by Liz Wood, back over to Koitza. Koitza for three, off, no good. Rebound this time, it is Snow. Snow looks left side. Fruin for three, bingo. Big turn of events there. 47-41, Maine calls a timeout. We'll take a timeout as well. This timeout presented by Quality Jewelers. Is it time for a new diamond or a diamond upgrade? If so, visit Quality Jewelers in the Penobscot Plaza, 57 Washington Street in Bangor. Maine 47, Missouri State 41. A minute 43 to play in the third. This is Black Bear basketball from Learfield Sports. Here, 47-41, but the Missouri State has scored six in a row. Winner and loser of this game will play the winner and or loser of Marist and LSU, which is our next game here at the Classic. Did you know that CFL light bulbs are recyclable and it's the law in Maine to recycle them? Stop by your local hardware store to recycle your used CFLs and visit lamprecycle.org to find a location near you. Maine with a basketball, up by six with a minute 40 to play here in the third. Charles looks over, Vekstrom open for three, bingo! Nothing but net. Eight for Sophie. 50-41, and Liz Wood came within a fingernail of having a steal. Missouri State inbounds the ball. Boy, Liz has had herself a ball game here today. Pass high, and Fruitt makes a nice jump to save it. Vanderwijde down their lane, right side, picks up the dribble, back to Fruin, quick catch three, bingo. And Fruin in double digits, and just like that, back-to-back threes from Fruin. And a steal by Snow. Snow into the forecourt. Snow, finger roll, got it. And we've got ourselves a ball game. It's gone from Maine up 11 to Maine up 4 with 45 seconds to play. In the third, 50-46. Here's Charles for three, off, no good. May have rushed that a bit. Rebound, Missouri State. Here they come into the forecourt. Three-pointer for Fruin, bingo! Fruin, three for three from behind the arc in the last couple of minutes, and all of a sudden, Maine's lead is down to one. 15 seconds of play in the third. Koitza splits a double team. Ziggy at the foul line, down the lane, her shot, no good. Foul, it will be on the floor. I believe that's what they appointed. It'll be Maine's ball out of bounds. 6.5 seconds to play. Bonine comes in. Charles comes out. Koitza, Heiser, Wood, Vekstrom, and Bonine for Maine. Fruin, Vanderweide, Snow, Buckley, and Quantel in there for Missouri State. Comes into Wood. Wood. Down to 4 seconds, Liz into the paint. Her fall away, off back iron, no good. We played through three. It's a 1-point ball game. Maine 1 for 7 and 2 for their last 10 from the field. Maine 50, Missouri State 49. Our fourth quarter is next. This is Black Bear Basketball from Learfield Sports. By 12, I beg your pardon. Maine was up 47 to 35. Missouri State finished that quarter on a 14 to 3 run, including a 6-0 run. And it was Snow and Fruin who went off for the Missouri State Bears. Friends, want to remind you that Maine basketball being brought to you by Miller's Workshop and Brewer, offering the best selection and price for men's and women's Carhartt workwear. University of Maine women's basketball proudly presented by Bangor Savings Bank. At Bangor Savings, you matter more. Missouri State, whose last lead was at 12-11, has the ball to begin this fourth quarter. Fruin, make that Vanderweide, now to Fruin at the top. With it, Buckley. Whistle, and there's going to be a foul on Maine right off the bat. Whom? That's on Liz. Fourth foul on Liz Wood. So Wood with four, Gustafson with four. Liz stays in the ball game. With a basketball, it is Vekstrom. Maine and a man-to-man. Fruin with a dribble. Fruin to Vanderweide. And that goes into the backcourt. Hit off her leg and went into the backcourt. 12th turnover. Gustafson will check in. Swan will check in. Wood and Heise come out. So Gustafson in with four. Wood comes out with four. Koitza with the ball. Koitza. Maine leads by one. Koitza dribbles through a double team, brings it back. And that ball is tipped. It goes into the backcourt and a backcourt violation. Six Maine turnover. Vander Whitey brings it over to the timeline. Vander Whitey looks to Snow. She has been red hot here this half. Snow, right side to Fruin, who has been very hot as well. Fruin, baseline jumper, off, no good. Rebound fought for, another offensive rebound. Quantel up, no good. Quantel again up, no good. Whistle and a foul on who? Maine. Bella Swan picks up the foul for Bella. Her first. Quantel at the line for Pear to give Missouri State the lead. First one to first tie it. It's good. Knotted at 50. Fifth tie of the afternoon. To give us our seventh lead change, she does. Missouri State on top. 51-50, so Maine has let a 12-point lead evaporate, and they've got foul trouble on top. Here's Koitza. Koitza over to Vekstrom. She'll take a three for the lead, off no good. Long rebound, Lauren Bodine. Bodine on the baseline looking for help. Her pass thrown away. Into the forecourt. Here's Fruin. Her shot no good. Rebound again offensive. Williams. Back to Snow. That ball did not hit the iron. Snow, that's going to be a charge, isn't it? Yes, it is. Snow lowered the shoulder and picks up her third. 51-50, Missouri State on top. 8:20 to play in the fourth. And a foul on Fruin in the backcourt. Leaning on Koitza. They've done a nice job on... Koitza, she's had five in the half, but they've really made her work a lot in this second half. Here's Vekstrom. Skip pass over to Koitza. Koitza with a dribble down at the elbow to Vekstrom. Right side, Bodine open for three in the lead. That's off. Long rebound. Can it be saved? No, it cannot. And Maine, according to my count, has missed eight straight threes. Seven for 24 on the day. And the Black Bears having what's been one of their Achilles heels going onto these little streaks where they can't score or don't score a lot. Here's Fruin for three, off no good. Long rebound. It's Vekstrom. She'll tap it to herself into the forecourt. Gives it off over to Koitza, to Vekstrom. Skip pass, left side, Bodine. Foul line, now to the right they go. To Vekstrom, goes baseline, back to Bodine. She'll square for three. Off, no good, doesn't hit anything. Out of bounds, and it will be a Missouri State basketball, and in comes Charles. Maine trails by a point. 7:10 to play. It's been a while since Maine has scored. Ball into the corner right side. Here is Williams. Williams runner off. No good. Rebound Koitza. Maine into the forecourt. Koitza looks to Charles. Back to Koitza at the top. Black Bears trail by a point. 6:45 to play here in the fourth. Koitza accelerates, drive, no basket. They're going to say the foul was on the floor. Rose comes back into the game for Snow to give her a breather. That foul was on Snow, and that's her fourth. Now with it, it's Koitsa, season opening, starts to drive, spin move, looks over, gets it back to Vekstrom, to Koitsa, almost deflected away, saved. Charles, back to Koitsa, 10 on the shot clock. She starts to drive, looks for a trailer, finds it in Swan, runner for Bella, it's good, and Maine takes the lead back. Second basket for Bella. Black Bears with a one-point lead, it's 52-51. And that ended a drought for Maine. They had not scored in the first 4 minutes of this quarter. Here's Fruin. That's going to be a foul. It's going to go on Vekstrom. Guess it depends on the angle. Second on Sophie. Thought there may have been a kind of a push by Fruin with a hand, but the official saying that Sophie made the contact before the forearm. Rose to inbound for Missouri State. Whistle. And Vekstrom picks up another foul. So Maine getting into some big-time foul trouble. Charles with three. Wood with four. Vekstrom with three. And Gustafson with four. Rose to inbound. Into the paint. The shot up. It is good for Quantel. And Missouri State back on top, 53-52. Bounce pass over to Koitsa. 5:40 to play. Wood getting ready to check back in for Maine with her four fouls. Here's Koitsa. Down the lane, her little jumper, got it! 22 for Ziggy, and Maine back on top. 54-53, 10th lead change in the basketball game. On the right side for Missouri State. Here comes Williams, her jumper, it's around and down, and Missouri State back on top, 55-54. 11th lead change. On the basket from Kenzie Williams. 5:05 to play here. Here's Koitsa. Looks over to the right side. It is a three for Vekstrom. Bingo! Sophie Vekstrom from downtown. Double digits for the senior. And Maine on top by a score of 57-55. And we've got 4:45 to play here in the fourth. Fruin, left foul and extended for Missouri State. Into the corner to Rose, the freshman. With the dribble, being guarded by Swan. Baseline jumper, Fruin for three. Off, no good. Rebound, Chantel Charles. Koitsa brings it into the forecourt. 4:25 to go. Crossover dribble. Ziggy at the foul line. Her runner. It's off front iron. No good. Rebound, Buckley. Here comes Missouri State. Whistle. Trouble. Timeout on the court. On the 14th turnover of the afternoon for Missouri State. 4:18 to play in the fourth. It's Maine 57. Missouri State 55. This is Black Bear basketball from Learfield Sports. the broadcast booth. U.S. Cellular, hello, better. Maine on top, 57-55. The Black Bears are 22 for 49 from the floor, 8 for 27 from behind the arc, 19 rebounds, 5 offensive, 7 turnovers. It's cost them 8 points. Missouri State is 20 for 47, 5 for 16 from behind the arc. They have 35 rebounds. They're out rebounding Maine by 16. They have 14 offensive rebounds. They have committed, though, 14 turnovers. That's cost them 11 points. As we mentioned, 11 lead changes, 5 ties. UMaine Women's Basketball proudly presented by Bangor Savings Bank. At Bangor Savings, you matter more. Liz Wood back into the ballgame, 4:19 to play. Wood, Koitza, Gustafson, Charles, and Beckstrom for the Black Bears, who lead here by 2. Koitza into the forecourt. Fruant, Snow, Williams, Buckley, and Quantel in there for Missouri State. With it, Koitza has some trouble, goes back down to Gustafson. Now Koitza, little up fake, baseline, Gustafson, spin move off the window, got it! Big basket for the Black Bears. Gustafson yanks it, a 59-55 lead for Maine. Here's Snow, she's been big the second half. Snow picked up by Koitza. Looks over to Williams, into the corner. Fruin open for 3. She's been red hot. That one, though, is no good. Rebound over the top. Quantrill. And a foul will go on Missouri State. Fourth foul on the team. Second on Quantrill. Koitza in the backcourt. She'll break the timeline. Into the corner to Charles. Back to Koitza. Koitza gonna stop and pop for 3. Bingo! Oh, Ziggy's 25, a career high. And the Black Bears build the lead to 7. Here's Fruant. Looks back out top. Now with it, it's Williams. Williams, her runner, off no good. Tapped up and in by Snow. Timeout, Missouri State. What a play there by Tiana Snow. She's got 19 on the day, and that was her 8th rebound, her 9th rebound, her 5th offensive. So it's 62-57. Maine on top here with 3:02 to play. The 25 points from Ziggy Koitza. It is the third time this year she's been 20-plus. 8th time in her career, career high 25. The previous was 23 last year against Stony Brook. If Maine holds on to win, we'll be back at 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon against the winner of the upcoming LSU-Marist game. If Missouri State rallies, we're back with you at 10:30 tomorrow morning against the loser of that aforementioned game. Here's Koitza. Down the lane, reach around. Fruant picks up the foul, and it will send Ziggy to the foul line. First trip on the day, 17 for 19 on the year, 90% for the Black Bear Junior. Maine as a team shooting 74% on the year from the line after going 71% last year. Who was the is there a question on the foul? I think there's a question on if it's the 5th foul, and it is the 5th foul. So it'll be Koitz at the line to add to her career high. And the first one is good. Koitz have been double digits all 7 games this year. The last 5 games last year. Second one, it is off, no good. There's a rarity. She misses a free throw. Rebound is Snow. So she's got a double-double. Inside shot, no good. Charles picks up the foul. And for Chantel, that's her 4th. 63-57. And the one thing I'm sure Coach Richard Barron doesn't want is the clock stop for free throws to be taken. Snow 3 for 3 on the day, 15 for 20 on the year from the charity stripe. And the first one, it is good. And gives her 20 points. The 10th season of the Black Bear Insider is on the air. The Black Bear Insider airs every other Sunday throughout the year on WVII Channel 7 in Bangor. Tune into the Black Bear Insider every other week for an inside look at Maine athletics. The second one, it is good. 21 for Snow. 63-59, Maine on top. 2:40 to play. Wood brings the ball into the forecourt. Liz gets it off over to Vekstrom. Now with it, Koitsa. Maine tries to spread the court a bit. They go to Charles. The bounce pass almost taken away, but it gets to Wood. Maine resets. 13 on the shot clock. 2:25 of the game clock. Spin move. Now they give it to Wood. Wood at the elbow. She takes the jumper. That's off. Long rebound, Fruent. Fruent into the forecourt. Racing it up from Missouri State. At the elbow. Gives it to Snow. Snow puts the dribble down at the elbow. Starts to drive. Splits a double team and makes a pretty move. 63-61. 2 minutes to play. Maine's lead is down to two. And the ball knocked away. Knocked away from Koitsa. Here comes Snow down the lane. Shot no good. Great defense by Wood. Rebound tied up. Possession arrow, Maine. Charles got her hand in there. Liz Wood played great defense. She got herself set for Snow to move. Look, if there's a collision, one of them's going out. They both got four fouls. And that allowed the shot to get changed. Timeout called with a minute 49 to play here in the fourth quarter. And I can tell you, the people who are organizing this tournament are loving this. I mean, they've had some great ball games, but this one has been all that it was built up to be, and it's been a very, very entertaining basketball game. For 20 years, the Learfield Sports Director's Cup has remained the crowning achievement in college athletics, honoring the nation's best overall programs in each division for men's and women's competitive excellence. Follow your favorite teams at thedirectorscup.com on Twitter or Facebook. And for updates in USA Today. A minute 49 to play. Maine 63. Missouri State 61. It's Maine's ball in the backcourt. Wood will inbound to Koitsa. They will pressure Ziggy the whole way up. Williams will. And Koitsa with a left-handed dribble breaks the timeline. Koitsa gives it over to Vekstrom. Her bounce pass and a whistle of foul. Going to go on Fruent. Second on Fruent. And it sends Koitsa to the line. I'm going to check that. Vekstrom to the line for two. And this is her first trip to the foul line this year. First one for Sophie is good. 12 on the day for the senior who last year shot 70% from the foul line. One more. Rattles around and out. Rebound Buckley. So it remains a one possession ball game. 64-61. Fruent to tie for three. Off, no good. Rebound, tie up. Loose, and no, they're going to give it a tie-up, and it's going to be a Missouri State ball as Buckley, Snow, and Koitsa all had a hand on that basketball. Bella Swan's going to check in. Wood's going to come out on the defensive end with the four fouls. I'm sure Richard Barron is going to try to go offense-defense with Liz. Fruent inbound. Fruent comes into Quanto, almost taken away. Fruent, her shot up, left-handed, too strong. Rebound, Chantel Charles. Now Koitsa into the forecourt to Charles. Bounce pass. Gustafson back to Koitsa. A minute 10 to play. 18 on the shot clock. Both teams with the bonus. Here's Koitsa. Looks over to Charles. Three-point lead for Maine. Down to a minute. Koitsa accelerates. Kicks it out. Vekstrom for three. In and out. Rebound, Missouri State. Into the forecourt. Snow steps through. Runner good. 25 for Snow. Maine leads by one. 64-63. 40 seconds to go. Koitsa. Picked up on a double team. Gives it to Bella. Swan over to the corner. Here's Vekstrom for three again. Off, no good. Long rebound picked up by Snow. They have a chance. Here comes Missouri State. Down the lane, charge, and she falls out of the game. Lowered her shoulder. Koitsa tucked a charge. She lowered her shoulder. And for Snow, she falls out with a double-double, 25 points, 11 rebounds. .2 seconds to go. Of course, it's a offensive foul, so there's no shooting foul shots on this. The lead official, Lisa Mattingly, is talking with the Missouri State coach, Kelly Harper. Richard Barron was asking for a timeout almost immediately, so I think it's going to be a Maine ball, and I think they want to get it into the forecourt. So the discussion now going on between the three officials. If you were with us at halftime, Debbie Antonelli. Well, maybe we are going to shoot foul shots. Would there have been a technical with that? Well, I'm not sure, but Ziggy's going to shoot foul shots, and the first one is good. She'll have one more. Second one, it's good. The only thing I could think that there may have been a technical foul assessed, I don't know. University of Maine Women's Basketball presented by Bangor Savings Bank. At Bangor Savings Bank, you matter more. So it's going to be Maine's ball into the forecourt. Well, it's been a great ball game, back and forth, 11 lead changes. Five ties. Maine had an 11-point lead. Only to see Missouri State come all the way back and take the lead. Actually, check that. A 12-point lead Maine had. 47-35. Missouri State went on a 14-3 run to end the first quarter. Maine's lead was at one. Missouri State took the lead twice, I think three times in the fourth quarter, but never more than by 1 point. Wood back into the ballgame. 21.2 seconds to play. Ball goes through the hands of Vekstrom, picked up by Gustafson, who was right there. Liz Wood with a basketball. They're going to have to foul her, and they do. Buckley will get the foul. Her second. Liz will go to the free throw line. An opportunity to shoot two to make it a two-possession ball game for Liz. Only has 2 points in the second half, but does have 13 in the game. Became the 10th all-time leading scorer today. First one is good. Liz passing Tracy Fredette and Ashley Underwood on the all-time scoring list. Fredette was at 1194. Underwood at 1195. Wood now at 1200. Misses the second. 1200 plus. The ball rebounded and picked up, and Missouri State will call the timeout with Maine leading by three. They did give a technical foul to Snow, according to the live stats. And now I see where that is on the live stats. My man, Tyson McHadden, keeping me in line. You miss Tyson here. He's up in Orono keeping everything together. But sometimes this goes so fast, you try to find something on live stats and you don't see it. So that's why we shot the foul shots. There was a technical foul. 15 seconds to go. Missouri State has the ball. They're down four. Maine 64, Maine 67, Missouri State 63. Snow is fouled out. Fruin has three on the Missouri State side. On the Maine side, Liz Wood, Chantel Charles, Michaela Gustafson, all with four fouls. Sophie Vekstrom with three. And somehow Ziggy Koitza has remained unscathed. Missouri State picked to win the Missouri Valley Conference. Maine picked to finish second in America East. And we are seeing two very, very, very good programs at the mid-major level. No question about it. Buckley will inbound for Missouri State. Lobs it. Quantel, who puts up the shot, got it. Nice catch and finish by Hillary Quantel. Quantel in double digits, and then it'll be a foul on the inbound pass as it comes in to Koitza. 67-65, Maine's lead is at two. 12 seconds to go. The foul will be the third on Kenzie Williams. Koitza at the line. On the afternoon, she is 3 for 4. 4 for 5 now. 29 points for Ziggy. Smashing her career high. This foul shot would give her not only 30, but give Maine a 2-possession lead. And it bounced around on the rim 4 times and went through. Athletic Director Carlton Creech down at the end, pacing, trying to do a little body English to get that ball to fall through. 10 seconds ago, here's Rose into the forecourt. Rose down the lane, lays it up, missed the layup, rebound, fought for it. Liz Wood comes away with it. Maine gets the outlet pass, and the Black Bears have won. Maine with a 69-65 victory over Missouri State, a hard-fought game. I know how much Richard Barron, the Maine coach, and Kelly Harper, the Missouri State coach, respect each other because Richard served on her staff when she was at North Carolina State. A very, very good ball game. They, right now, at midcourt, Coach Barron and Coach Harper exchanging a hug. Maine earns the victory to improve to 4-3 on the year, and Richard will work his way over here to us. Let him get the headphones on, and then we will chat with him. All right, Coach, that was hard fought. But
yes, it was. We knew it would be.
And it really was, as I said here just a moment ago, two great mid-major programs going head-to-head, and this was a wonderful basketball game.
Yeah, it was a really clean first half, I think, even for both teams, although I'm sure that, you know, being behind, they probably felt like they could have done better in the first half. But I thought then they junked things up, you know, to really try to disrupt us, and for the most part, we handled it well. We saw some people make some shots. We talked about others needing to step up. Sophie hit some big shots there. Chance had a nice one. Bella, you know, contributed in the second half. So I thought that was great, that it wasn't just the Siggy and Liz show in the second half like it was the first half. So that was good. And to do it against, I mean, it's very hard to simulate what they were doing. They're scrambling and trapping, and it's a kind of a zone, but it looks man. And so we expected that. I mean, you know, teams are they have a hard time guarding us, you know, straight man or guarding a straight zone. So, you know, they're going to try to do some different things. And that's a great coaching staff. And I knew, you know, I told them they're going to throw something at you. Well, I don't know what it's going to be, but they're going to throw something at you. So, you know, we did a really good job until the very end of the third half. I mean, 22 was a bulldozer in there.
Oh,
I mean,
she was phenomenal, yeah.
Tiana Snow, she was great. She is 25 points. We couldn't stay in front of her. She reminded me of Clyde Drexler. She was all right hand, but she'd still beat you on the left side. You know, she never touched it with her left. And so she was obviously really good. And then at the end of it, we gave three threes to number five.
Fruin.
Yeah, and you know, all three of them were, you know, were just two open looks. I mean, when I say two open, I mean T-O-O.
I know what you meant.
They were exceedingly open. And then the third one, our hands were down. Like, I mean, the kid just hit two, so what do you think she's going to do? She's going to pull up and hit a third. So that showed their toughness, and as I said before, the character of their, that team was reflected in, you know, by the character of their coaching staff. That we showed the toughness and made enough free throws down the stretch was tremendous. And, the rebounding obviously is something we want to address. We've got to do a better job. We were getting our hands on a lot of balls, but we weren't securing them.
They got a lot of offensive rebounds by batting them out, it seemed like, to me. And they did a nice job of that.
Right. And, you know, we made more threes. I think our shot selection was pretty good. And we had Siggy, you know, and they didn't. That was a big difference. Siggy with 30 points. Is that a career high
for
her?
That definitely is a career high for her, yes.
You know, and it's nice to be able to put the ball in someone's hands like that. And only 8 turnovers for us. That's a big thing. So we forced 15. Our blue defense was far better today. Our matchup defense was far, far better than it has been. So, we scrapped it yesterday for Dayton and went to all straight man. Today we were able to switch some things up.
Yeah, and Liz, even though she was in foul trouble, 13-8, 4 steals. She had some big steals for you, especially in the first half.
Yeah.
3 assists. And again, we talk about it numerous times. When you look at that stat sheet, I know the rebounds probably bothers you, but you got to love 18 assists, 8 turnovers. That's a 2-to-1 ratio, plus 2-to-1 ratio. You got to love that.
Yeah, no, exactly. It's the, you know, the 16 boards, and we're doing a good job to force the misses, and they're taking long threes, long rebounds. And we have it's such an instinct when a shot is taken to move towards the basket. And so any good offensive rebounding team is going to pin you underneath, and you're not going to get any, especially on those long rebounds. And it is, you know, it's easy to talk about. It's easy to talk about why it's broken. It's easy to talk about how to do it right. And it is very, very hard to do for whatever reason. It's something that's just so instinctive to go in, all right, instead of away from the basket on a shot. And when you do, you're going to give up positioning. So we've got to continue to focus on that. I'm excited now to watch, you know, LSU and Marist to see these two teams play. Marist gave Louisville a very good game yesterday, so they seem to be kind of coming into their own with a lot of turnover on their roster this year. And, LSU is – they're down a little bit in terms of their personnel. Their roster is down to, I think, 8 healthy players right now. So this ought to be a good game, and obviously we're going to be playing the winner. So, we hope that we're able to, you know, bring some momentum into that game tomorrow.
And I thought the good thing, I mean, you had a 12-point lead. It evaporates in the fourth quarter, but you come right back and you get the lead, and they take it back. I mean, like 3 quick lead changes for you, and that's something I would think, as you, when you reflect on it, you got to be pleased with that your team, even though they took that shot, they withstood the shot and answered back.
Yeah, absolutely. And we're not quite a fully healthy team.